Hi friends, now we will see the topic related to rules to draw ray diagrams for image formation by lenses. So from the title we can understand that we are drawing the image by following some rules through the lenses. So let's go to the topic, that is rules are as follows. So one by one we will check it out. So for locating position and to find the size of image, we need two rays out of four rays that were mentioned in situations 1 to 4. So in my previous video, I already explained about four situations. Among the four situations, we will take two rays, the two rays which will make up the image formation. So let's go to the first point, that is select a point on the object placed at a point on the principal axis. So I have taken an object, the object I placed on the principal axis, and on the object I choose one point. So I chosen on the top. So it is the base of an object, it is the top of the object. So the base, it is in contact with the principal axis. So the image base will also in contact with the principal axis. Coming to top, the important points we have to take, that is the top I have taken. That is the point C. Select a point on the object placed at a point on the principal axis. So on the object top I have taken the point, the selected point. Next, draw two rays that were chosen by you from rays mentioned in the situations 1 to 4. So again the point is important C. So don't neglect my previous video, try to check it out. Next, according to this point, we have to choose two rays, the two rays which are passing from the object. So I have chosen one ray which is parallel to principal axis and another ray which is passing through the optic center. So we know the ray which is passing through the optic center and the ray which is passing through the principal axis does not deviate. So these two rays will be straight. Coming to the ray which is parallel to principal axis, after refraction that ray will get deviate, means as it is a convex lens, I have taken convex lens. So as the property of convex lens, after the refraction the light ray will get converge. So this is the case. Next, extend both rays to intersect at a point. This point gives the position of the image. So we know I have taken two rays, that is one ray parallel to the principal axis, another ray which is passing through the optic center. So these two rays we have to pass to certain distance after passing the convex lens. So the optic center, it will go, the ray will go straight in the optic center, and the ray after refraction, the ray which is parallel after refraction, it will go it will go like converging ray towards the optic center ray. The both rays will meet at one point. Next, draw a normal from point of intersection to the principal axis. So as the both rays are intersecting at one point, we have to draw one ray towards the principal axis, and this ray is the normal ray. Again we have to draw one straight perpendicular ray. This is the image formed. So next, length of this normal represents the size of the image. So as much as normal you are getting, this is the size of the image. Next, in short I will explain. See, we have to take the object on the principal axis at any other positions. So I have not mentioned any C, the center of curvature or focal point, because as it is example I have not taken any points, just I have taken one principal axis. On this principal axis I place the object. After placing the object, the two ends, one will be the base will be on the principal axis, and the top, for the top I have taken two rays. One ray is passing parallel to the principal axis, another ray is passing through the center, optic center. Next, we know the ray which is passing parallel to the principal axis, after the refraction it will get converge at its convex lens. Coming to optic center, the ray will not deviate, so the ray will be straight. Next, we have to extend the rays, that both rays we have to extend in such a way that they will meet at one point. This is the point the image is formed. So after forming the point, we have to make one normal line towards the principal axis. So this, the normal line will show us the size of the image. This is the total about the rules. The rules are important to draw any image for concave lens and convex lens. So let's go to our one more topic, that is image formation by concave lens. So image formation by concave lens, the few precautions we have to take. So concave lenses, what is the property? as the concave lenses diverges, we know the concave lenses always diverge the image. The rays which are coming to concave, the rays will get diverge. This is the diagram. Let's see. As the concave lenses diverges, the rays which are passing through them, so irrespective of the positions of the object on the principal axis, you will get an erect virtual image diminished in size in between focal point and optic center of the concave lenses. So according to this point, we can say that as the ray is getting diverged after refraction, we won't get the images after the refraction. We will get the images before the lens only. That is, see, the rays, we will get the erect image and the image which is called as a virtual and a diminished, the size is diminished, small image. So the same rays are one ray, parallel ray. As it is concave lens, the ray will get diverged. Next, the optic center, we know it is the straight point. Next, we have to join the two rays. So with the dotted lines, I will join the two rays. So this is the case, we will get the normal line. And this normal, this is the image. So the image is, see, it is erect, virtual and diminished image. So according to this point, is saying that the position of object anywhere on the principal axis, we will get same property of the image. So the property is simple, see, erect image we will get, virtual image we will get and diminished in size we will get. This is the cases of concave lenses. Next, note I have taken, so short note, according to the positions of object on principal axis, we will get the images varying with different sizes, erect or real or virtual or inverted. So compared to this, it is maximum suitable for the convex lens. See, according to the positions, so I already said on the principal axis, if you change the position of the object, the image size and its properties overall will getting changing. Coming to the next point, maximum we get inverted and real in convex. So this is the case. If you take the convex lens, maximum we will get inverted image, real image, and the size will be according to the position, or diminished, or the size will be enlarged, it will be according to the position. Next, coming to concave, see, erect and virtual image in the concave lenses. This is the case. So for your better understanding of situation 1 to 4 of rays, try to check my previous video, I will give the link. Since we have seen image formation through concave lenses, in my next video I will upload the image formation through convex lens. So the next video is important in the case of image formation by any lenses. So try to check my next video.